All right, guys, here we are. Okay, workout Wednesday. Okay, HomeWod edition. So if you're hitting the wads at home, this is another great one with little to no workout equipment. The only thing that you're gonna need is, if you want, it's optional, just a mat. Or you can use just your carpet surface. Get something that can protect the knees or can protect the body from getting any kind of burns or anything like that. This is more than okay to do on a wood floor or any other type of surface, but just for my type of comfort, I prefer a mat, and I bet some of you prefer one as well. All right, so here we go. Today, I'm going to be coaching through this and kind of guiding you guys with my lovely voice and my athlete of the day, Woody Harrelson, and I'll be Wesley Snipes here, okay? So, hopefully some of you guys caught that reference. All right, so today, guys, we have three parts to this workout. We have our warm-up, which we're gonna take you through in just a second here, and then we have our workout here, which will be a Tabata style workout. And then right after that, we have our cool down, which is gonna be a post-WOD stretch here today, all right? So without further ado, here we go. We're gonna go into our warm up today. So we're gonna demonstrate a couple movements for you and then give you guys plenty of time to go through that yourself. All right, so first movement is gonna be in this warm up, in this 6 minute AMRAP, is gonna be 20 jumping jacks. So a shakeup goes on the jumping jacks. There's a little bit of difference on the jumping jack today. You're gonna be going all the way up overhead as you traditionally go, and then I want you to go behind your back and actually touch your hands together, okay? So he's just going with the traditional jumping jack here. If you are unable to do a jumping jack like this, then we want you to kind of go out with what we call like a side jack, which your hands still go over your head, feet come out, and your hands are still gonna be behind your back. Every time you step out, that's one repetition, and you're gonna continue that until you get to 20, okay? All right, after that, the next movement is gonna be the glute bridge, okay? So laying on your back for this one, couple things, points of reference here. Two things, if you feel too much of your hamstrings or your low back while you're doing this, then I want you to move your feet closer to your butt. What that does is that eliminates or really reduces how much the hamstrings or the low back plays into that. We want you to squeeze your butt up to the sky. As you're squeezing your butt up to the sky, I want you to think $100 bill, walnut, something in there that you're trying to crush, all right? And you're not trying to get the glute bridge the highest possible. You're trying to squeeze as hard as possible. So not trying to get the hips up as high as possible. You wanna make sure you're squeezing as hard as possible here, okay? So we're going for 10 repetitions here. All right, to our next movement, we're gonna move over to the 30-second plank, okay? So this would just be a static hold here. Several variations of this. We have the conventional plank here where Jacob's arms are completely under his shoulders here, nice tight back, glutes are squeezed, legs are straight here. You can also go from the elbow position here. And this is where that mat may come into play as you're kind of protecting your elbows here. Again, nice flat back. Elbows are still directly under his shoulders here. Nice flat back as he goes down. And then also we can do this on the knees. We can do both variations on the knees. So we have here, elbows are under shoulders. He has his butt squeezed and almost like he's kind of making a hollowed position to get his abs here. And you can also do this on his elbows as well. And again, we're gonna hold this position for 30 seconds. All right. So, just demonstrated both those movements. We'll be back to you, and we're gonna perform this workout here. Okay, guys, hope you're ready here. We're gonna start this warm-up in 10 seconds. Three, two, one, and go. What we want you to think about when you're doing this warm-up here is your first round, you're taking it nice and easy, you're getting some movement, you're getting some blood flow in your body here. As the time starts to count down, I want you to increase that intensity. I want you to get a good deep sweat. That full range of motion on that jumping jack is a really small little thing, but it is a game changer. You're gonna feel your shoulders warmed up a little bit more. You have a little bit more flexibility going here. As you're moving through, move with the purpose, but take your time. The glute bridges don't need to be rushed. If you're gonna rush any movement or make any movement faster, I would really focus on the jumping jacks. Maybe increasing the frequency or the speed of the jumping jack, but allowing yourself to really get that heart rate up, get those ankles, those calves, those arms, those shoulders, your breathing, and just your body temperature up here. Jacob's moving to the plank here. Let's see what variation he chooses, okay? Going with the elbows and toes variation here. Nice flat back, legs are straight here. Good, and we'll hold it for 30 seconds. All Nice job. Good. So this round here, now we're going to go just a little bit faster on those jumping jacks. Speed it up just a little bit. So the first round, a round is going to take you about a minute to a minute and a half. And then you just speed it up a little bit. The next round may take you about a minute to a minute and 20 seconds. Just a little bit faster as you're moving here with the purpose. And again, remember, if that first round you started feeling your hamstrings doing more work, pull those feet to your butt so you can push those hips up. That'll keep your hamstrings and low back from doing any additional work there. Good. We're starting round number three, and again, that was just a little bit faster than the last one there, so he had about 10 to 15 seconds faster than his first round, and we just kind of keep increasing that pace, keep increasing that intensity as we go. When you're by yourself, maybe if you're in the living room or wherever, what room you are in your house, you're doing this workout, focus on as much as possible as your quality of movement. If you feel yourself getting fatigued, well, you should, but while you're feeling yourself getting fatigued, focus on your form. As best as you can, focus on your form here. Good, as we're going through this round, I believe this is round number four for Jacob here, so you're gonna have a little bit of time left. Go ahead and push that pace as you get ready for your last round here of that warm up. You're gonna get a few minutes. I'm gonna recommend that you take about 3 to 4 minutes before that you start actually doing the workout itself. Get a nice little break. Good time to use the bathroom. And get some water, get your towel, get ready to rock and roll. I will start this time if you're not ready to go. Guys, got about 20 seconds left here. So you have a few minutes left in that plank position. I encourage you here, maybe try to do a difficult variation of that plank just for a few seconds. There we go. We got 5 seconds left. Here we go in 3, 2, 1, and rest. Nice job, guys. I want you to go ahead and take some time. Use the bathroom, get your towel, get your water bottle, and get ready to rock and roll for the workout. Be back to you in a minute. All right, guys, and we're back. So, with today's HomeWod, Wednesday WOD, We're gonna go over the workout today. So this is a Tabata style workout. That means we're going to be doing intervals of 20 seconds of work, and then we're gonna be doing 10 seconds of actual rest, okay? Very similar to if you had a chance to do the workout yesterday, the workout yesterday was a cool down that was set up with 20 seconds on of work and 10 seconds of rest. So we're just gonna use this for the format of the actual workout today. So it's gonna be 24 rounds, and we're gonna be cycling through three different movements. So every 20 seconds of rest, you're doing a different movement today, all right? So we have mountain climbers is gonna be movement number one, jumping lunges is gonna be movement number two, and a Y Superman hold, Y like YMCA Superman hold today. So we're gonna take you through mountain climbers and the variations that we wanna see you apply today, okay? So with the standard variation of a mountain climber here, Jacob's gonna have his hands underneath his shoulders here to start, and he's gonna start with a nice tight body position. As he brings his knee up, it taps kind of mid foot area here, and you're touching those feet every single time. Nice quick touch and taps here. As he's going, you can see his hips rise a little bit, but not very much. We wanna keep that as level as we can throughout that. Okay, so a couple modifications here. The next one would be hands on a chair, right? Or on a couch or something like that you can hold here. You can still do the fast toe touch tap in between here, but if that becomes too strenuous, what I would suggest doing is bringing both feet up, one, two, and then stepping back, one, two. Good point of emphasis to keep that core tight is to make sure that your butt doesn't rise as you do this, right? Keeping the hands on the shoulders, you're gonna get a nice shoulder burn while you're doing that, okay? So that's for both athletic and health. And all of these notes will be on SugarWOD here as well. Okay, so next movement is gonna be the alternating jumping lunges, okay? Very dynamic movement here, and this one will get you sore. So we start with knee on the ground, shin is vertical here, nice upright chest. Jacob is going to jump and switch his legs midair, and then land onto the other, switching legs in the air, and then landing on and touching that knee. So right here, just like that. Now this can be sped up and done quite quick. So as you see in advance to this movement, that's gonna be done very fast. Now, a couple variations of this. The next one would be just a reverse lunge. Stepping back, touching the knee, making sure the knee stays out. You're not letting it go over the toe or letting the knee dip in on this position here, okay? And then the health standard of that would just be in either an air squat or we'd go right to a box squat here, okay? Get a movement where you can touch that box, you come to a complete stop, nice tight position, and then you're able to stand up and extend the hips at the top, okay? All right, and for the last movement here, I'm gonna move this box out of the way here for just a moment. So we have a Y Superman hold, okay? So again, arms are gonna be into this kind of Y position with the thumbs facing upwards here, okay? As he starts to lift, we wanna make sure his butt squeezed, legs are extended straight out, and his head is not too far up, not too far down, it's kind of neutral, and you're gonna feel your scapulas here, your shoulder blades here, all nice and tight and stretched as you're going up. And rest, go ahead and rest, Jacob. So as he's doing that, you should be feeling your shoulder blades here and your butt and your hamstrings and a little bit of your back as well. It shouldn't be majority back, okay? Now as you get fatigued, those shoulders are gonna start burning really heavy. You may start to feel your back fatigue a little bit more, but that's a natural part of the progress. Just take small breaks in between that. You recover very quickly on this movement. All right, so a couple modifications for this. You can go back to a regular Superman, which is just arms out, palms are facing down here, holding to that position right there. Also, it would just be, you can go to a plank. Plank would be the other variation here. Now that's the hardest variation of the plank that we'll be doing here, or you can go back down to the elbows, or you can also do this on your knees with the elbows or hands position there. Okay? All right. Last time to use the bathroom, because we're about to get this thing on, okay? All right, so here we go. We're gonna be following the clock here. So again, you're gonna be cycling through movements, the mountain climbers, the jumping lunges, as well as that Superman hold here. And we're gonna be starting in 10 seconds. In 3, 2, 1, and go. and rest. In 3, 2, 1, and go. In 3, 2, 1, and rest. Good, moving on here to that Y Superman hold here. And go. Good, and as we're going through this, guys, you're not looking to blow out any particular round with your pace. You wanna be smooth and consistent throughout that pace. Your goal and objective is to move throughout the workout without taking very many breaks. You wanna try to move consistently and smoothly throughout that process. Be mindful of your breathing, continue to breathe. 2, 1, nice job, Jacob. There we go. So we're going back to mountain climbers here, starting in 3, 2, 1, and go. Notice that you're continuing to keep your back flat as you're moving, hands staying under the shoulders. Nice smooth taps here, and rest. Good, and rest. Go. Go, we're going back to that plank here. Or if you're doing that Superman, you have a regular Superman hold here. Or you're going with that Y Superman with a thumbs up here. Nice and tight glutes. You still have to breathe in this position. Try not to hold yourself for, you hold your breath for that 20 seconds. Make sure you're breathing. And rest. Good, as your heart rate gets up, it's gonna be harder and harder to kind of not move while you're doing that Superman hold. Just be cognizant of that. Move nice and smooth as you're getting ready. Take a deep breath before you begin your next round and get ready to rock and roll here. Do your best to maintain that form while you're doing this. These slight and small body weight movements can sometimes seem like they're not as important to keep your form on. They're just as important because you're doing so many repetitions of them. Try keeping a nice, smooth rhythm the entire time. 2, 1, nice job. Keep it going. Good, do your best to keep your shins as vertical as possible. Nice upright chest as you're moving through this. If you start to feel your chest dip down, take a pause in between the set. Take a pause, we want you to do it right and not sloppy here. We always want to emphasize and protect form over speed here. Back and hamstrings and hips, glutes and upper shoulders should start really burning here as you're going through that. So just try to find a zen moment here in this process and keep on moving. If it gets to a point where it's getting too intense for you, feel free to lay down. Take a break in between that interval, take a break off, and then continue on to the next round here. Three, two, one. Nice job, guys. Keep on moving. Keep on moving. Starting another round here. We're gonna keep moving nice and smooth here. Find that even pace that you can hold and keep on holding it. Good trick here is to maybe just slow down just a hair. As you're going through, you wanna keep moving the entire time. You don't have to necessarily keep the same pace. We'd love for that, but just move a little bit slower as you're moving in between. That'll keep you moving, keep that heart rate up. Almost to the mountain, my friends. We're almost to the mountain. Nice job. There we go. Going back to those alternating jumping lunges. So as your legs start to get a little tired, focus on the form, even is more important. And just again, you can move a little bit slower. Maybe you started out doing jumping lunges every round, starting to get a little tough where you start to feel like your chest was dipping really low. Move to a reverse lunge. Slow the pace down a little bit, but I want you to keep moving. Keep on moving. Nice hold here. Arms are up. Shoulders are flexed. Nice wide position. Go. Holding those thumbs up. And three, two, one.
you go.
Almost to the mountain, my friends. Almost there. Almost there, folks. Almost there. Hang in there. Here we go. Get it right, get it tight. Keep it right and keep it tight. Let's go. There you go. As you start to get fatigued, try to keep your chest up as much as you can. As you're moving through that, there we go. We're almost there here. Hold here. We go. We got 20 seconds here. Nice job. I believe that should be it. Let's just check here. And we're done. See, it was easy. All right, guys, so here we are with the cool down today here. We're gonna be doing some dynamic stretching as we've did so many lunges here, and take care of that back and those mountain climbers that were all so much fun. So we're gonna take care of those shoulders. And we're gonna focus on our quads here with this couch stretch. We're gonna show you several variations of this that you can do at the house. And for all of different abilities, whether you have the ability to lean on your knee or not, I'm gonna show you how to kind of take care of this, okay? So we're gonna start out with the first variation I would use, and this is literally how you can use your couch. So if your couch is about this high from the seating position, have some type of pad, usually a pillow. And then there's a couple points that we wanna make sure that you have no matter what, okay? One, chest must be vertical. Okay, we don't want you really leaning on. So one of my cheater moves is use a chair to sit up on, get your phone in your hand and distract yourself. Okay, or if you already have your chest vertical and you can get your knee closer to the box because you're not really feeling a stretch, do that. Try to get it as close as you can, but with maintaining an upright chest. Okay, let's say you can't put your knee on the ground. So here's the next modification here. Pretending that this is a counter, or maybe it's the back of the couch, you can bring your foot to the back of that here, just like that. And you're gonna sit back just a little bit here and kind of feel, and as you sit back, you sink down just a little bit and you can feel that quad working there. Again, keeping a nice vertical chest and vertical torso as you're doing that movement there, okay? All right, and so we're gonna hold that position for 2 minutes, okay? We're gonna hold each one of these positions for 2 minutes here. We're gonna go through these movements first and then we'll actually start a timer and do some stretching. Okay, so next one here is the leg hug here. We're gonna do this for 1 minute each side here. So we're crossing over our legs. Your foot, you wanna make sure your ankle passes your knee here. So ankle passing the knee. And what we're doing here as we're hugging is wrapping the arms around and pulling that knee to us. We're pulling that leg to us. We're gonna feel that in this little muscle, this tiny little glute muscle called the piriformis. Helps with your squats and your lunges here. Takes tension off your knees. So we wanna pull that nice and tight here, keeping an upright chest and kind of breathing through as you're pulling yourself closer and closer together. And again, we're gonna do that for 1 minute. Then we're gonna switch legs and repeat on the other side here, okay? One side may be more flexible, less flexible than the other. And that's okay. You're just gonna if you have more time, spend a little bit more time stretching that additional side there, okay? All right, and then for the last movement up here, we're gonna do a scorpion stretch here. Now, typically when we do a scorpion stretch, we're emphasizing the back, the low back here. We're gonna emphasize the shoulder here, okay? So we're still gonna do the same position here as Jacob stretches away. So right arm is down and we want it parallel. So like you're forming like a T. As he pushes away from here, we're gonna do this in two positions here. So we're gonna have the palm facing the ground, and about halfway, about 30 seconds in, we wanna flip to where the palm is now facing upwards here, and that stretches the shoulder in two different ways. The left hand that he's posting here is to push up and really stretch that shoulder here. And we're gonna do this 1 minute each side. All right, so as he rotates, you're just gonna rotate to the other side here. Good, now he's posting the right hand, palm is down for the first 30 seconds, and he'll go ahead and flip. Palm will be up for the last 30 seconds here, and again, posting the arm here. All right, good job. All right, guys, here we are. We're gonna start out with a couch stretch here. Again, grab your phone. Grab something that you can use to distract you here. And here we go. In 10 seconds, we're gonna start stretching here. Nice upright chest. Get somewhere where you can relax and just allow yourself to enjoy the stretch here. We're gonna go 2 minutes per side. All right, guys, you're just a little bit over a minute here. Let's hang out. Got about 50 more seconds here. Look at him. He's just texting. He looks happy. He's even smiling right now. It's that easy. All right, guys, got about 15 seconds left here. We're gonna stretch that. Sometimes while you're stretching on that quad, you're gonna feel like the pressure's released. Even though you're in the same position, that just means that the muscles have actually allowed themselves to relax here. Now we're gonna go ahead and switch sides here. Good opportunity to move around for just a second before you go back onto the leg. Kind of feel the difference in. You can retest with a squat or a lunge to see how much difference it made in that additional field here. We're gonna go on and go on to the other side here, and we're gonna stretch for an additional 2 minutes. So we started around the 2:15 mark here, so we have about another minute, just a little over a minute before we switch to the next exercise here. One of my favorite times to surf the Facebookers or the Instagrams or the YouTubes is while I'm doing this stretching. Or if you're a fan of TikTok, you can use that too.
Or if your wife is texting you, you text back.
Or, in this case, if your wife is texting you, you can text back. All right, guys, if you're keeping track of where we are, here we have another, right when it gets to 4 minutes, we have another 15 seconds to end up exactly 2 minutes on this side as well here. All right, and rest. Good. Now we're going to move to the 1 minute leg hugs here. All right, starting it right at the about 4 minutes and 30 second mark here. Go right into that leg hug. He's hugging his left leg, that is the leg that is feeling the stretch right around that glute area here at the bottom. Here we go, we got about 5 seconds here in 3, 2, 1, and let's switch sides. All right, here we go, we're starting right at about the 5 minute and 45 second mark, so we're gonna go 1 minute from there. All right, guys, got about 20 more seconds here. All right, here we go in 5 seconds. In 3, 2, 1, nice job. We got one stretch left here. Go right into that scorpion stretch, and I'm gonna guide you when you need to flip your hand up here. All right, so here we go. Good, remember as we switch and post to that side here, we're gonna post one hand down using the other leg, arm, to prop us up here. We've been going for about 10 seconds here. We got about 20 seconds left, and then we're gonna switch. I'm gonna tell you to lift the hand that is, the arm that is stretched out. We're going to flip that palm upwards here in 10 seconds. In 3, 2, 1, go ahead and flip that palm upwards here. Don't know if you can see that here. His palm is flipped upward there. There we go. All right, here we go in 5 seconds. We're gonna switch arms in 3, 2, 1, and we're switching here. Propping the other arm up here, pushing away. Although you will feel this a little bit in your torso and your back, this is emphasized really to push and work on the shoulder here. All right, in 5 seconds here, we're gonna move on to flipping that palm upwards in 3, 2, 1. Good, and as you can see, palm is flipped upwards here. All right, got about 5 seconds left here in 3, 2, 1, and you're done. Nice job, guys. See ya mañana. Love to see you post some scores under the video that we post on Facebook, or go ahead and post in SugarWOD. It will be under the DT60, still the same workout feed as usual. You can post your workout result if you've kept the reps in line, or you can just mark that as a checkbox. Thanks, guys. Bye-bye.